let's look at the code that I wrote for the Luhns checksum. And this is pretty sort of, this is kind of redundant bad code, but I wrote it quickly and I think it works. So we have the Luhns checksum function, and the first thing it does is looks at the length of its argument. That is to say, looks at the length of the string over which it's going to compute a checksum. It's also going to initialize the checksum variable to be zero. Now, if we're computing a checksum over an even number of digits, the remainder mod 2 is going to come out to zero. So in this case, we're going to loop over the digits in the checksum. That is, the range L goes from 0 to the length minus 1. And here what I'm going to do is add 1 to that number so that we can get a 1-base numbering system like I showed you in the explanation of Luhns' algorithm. So here now, if we're at digit 0 in Python, we're at digit number 1 in the 1s-based human numbering system. And so if that comes out to be 0 when modded with 2, now we're at an even-numbered digit. So in that case, we're going to add the value of that digit into the sum. Otherwise, we're going to call this Luhns digit function on the same value. And the Luhns digit function is just sort of the obvious thing. It multiplies the number by 2. If it's greater than 9, returns 9 less than the number. Otherwise, just returns the number. So now the other case is that we're checksumming an odd number of digits. And in that case, we have exactly the same logic, but with the even and odd cases flipped around. So here we're taking the Python 0-base digit, adding 1 to it to get a human 1s-base numbering system, modding that with 2. If it comes out to be even, we're doing the Luhns digit computation. If it's odd, then we're just adding in the value of the number. And finally, we get a checksum that we've accumulated here, and we take that mod 10, and that gives us our actual checksum value that we're going to use. So now, here's the algorithm for generating a valid random credit card number. So the inputs are, remember, a prefix and a total length in digits. So the number of random digits we're going to generate is the total length minus the length of the prefix minus 1 for the checksum digit. Now we're just going to assert that that's greater than 0 just to be careful. And now we're going to set n as our credit card number that's in progress. So we're going to initialize that to be just the prefix. Now for the number of random digits we have, we're just going to make up a random digit and append it to the string. Finally, we're going to add a 0 checksum to it and compute the Luhns checksum. If that Luhns checksum comes out to be 0, we're done. If that Luhns checksum comes out to be non-zero, we have to do the little inversion that I talked about, where we take the checksum, where we subtract the checksum from 10. And now what this little bit of logic does is strips off the last character, that's the 0 we added, from the credit card number, and adds on the checksum number. So that's how easy it is to generate a valid credit card number. And now the isLuhnValid function just checks if the Luhns checksum is 0.